Hey guys, welcome in. It's another edition of the FanDuel Hurry Up. I'm Joe Ranieri, joined by Thomas Vecchio of Number Fire, and we thought we'd talk a little baseball here today, but we're going to mix it up a little bit because the Yankees and Dodgers are ridiculous favorites, but we'll talk from a division title perspective. Let's start in the American League. And how about that Central? Why don't we talk about them Chicago White Sox as a possibility of winning the Central and those odds? Thomas, welcome in, my friend. Good to see you again.
How's it going? You know, we talked some basketball last week. We might as well flip over to some baseball. And like you said, we got the White Sox at plus 340. Really like that price point on them. You know, we have the Twins coming in this year, much of the same as what we saw last year. They added Josh Donaldson. We expect them to hit a ton of home runs. We have the Indians sitting at plus 290, but their offense really is lacking. Their pitching staff is, you know, has a bunch of question marks after, you know, Shane Bieber, obviously amazing, Mike Clevenger dealing with a ton of injuries. But we have the White Sox adding all these young players, calling up prospects, you know, making some key additions in the offseason with Grandal and Nomar Mazara and Edwin Encarnacion, Dallas Keuchel. Like, they're making the right moves. You know, Luis Robert is set to make his debut. Plus 340 for this team that has a good mix of pitching with Keuchel, Lucas Giolito, bringing up some young players at a really solid price point. I kind of like them this year. You know, this year moving forward, I'm not really too worried about the Indians. It's going to be up against the Twins, but man, take these young guns in Chicago with the White Sox.
Love their win total as well. I think they're going to eclipse the win total. I think that pitching staff in the front head of that order is going to score a lot of runs. So I'm with you 100% on the Chicago White Sox, certainly winning a lot more than people think they're going to. How about in the West? Obviously, Houston, a lot of focus on them heading into the year, but give me a dark horse, some team that you like the value on of winning that American League West title.
For the West, the Angels at plus 650 are really, really interesting, right? We know that the Astros have been there for the past number of seasons. We know that the Athletics are always there, kind of bouncing around in the wild card, always seem to make a bit of noise later in the season. But we have the Angels. They added Rendon this offseason. We know that the question for them has always been pitching, right? We have Mike Trout, this all-world, all-caliber player who has three MVPs under his belt. He has played in three career playoff games. Like, we need to get Trout and the Angels to the playoffs. For them, it always comes down to pitching. But they made a few upgrades. They bring in some, I would say, good pitchers with Dylan Bundy, Julio Teheran. They have Trout, obviously, still. Shohei Ohtani's getting healthier. They bring in Rendon. They have Upton. Like, the lineup is starting to pull together. So a plus 650, like, you are getting amazing odds on them. And really, no one else should be looking at them.
Can't figure out what Mike Trout's war is going to be this year now that he's got actual protection in the lineup there. I think Ohtani's going to be a key piece, along with their new manager, Joe Maddon. Should be a lot of fun to watch how it all unfolds there. And now let's take a look at the National League here, Thomas. And the East, for instance, that holds, I don't know, you know, the current World Series, the reigning World Series champs, the Washington Nationals. Talk to me about the National League East and who you think's got value there to win the division.
So the East is, I want to say, is probably one of the most interesting divisions for the NL this season. We know the Dodgers are super heavy favorites. We'll get to them in a minute. But the East, you know, we have the Braves. They've been solid for a few years. We have the Nationals sitting at plus 250. And besides the loss of Anthony Rendon to the Angels, as I just mentioned, nothing really changed for them. You know, we should see Carter Kieboom at third, you know, see a good amount of time this year. But their lineup is largely the same. They still have Scherzer, Corbin, and Strasburg as their starting pitching, like one of the best starting pitching staffs in the league. They still have Trey Turner, Soto, Robles. They bring in Starlin Castro and Eric Thames, which I think are really good, like mid-tier pickups, like guys you don't need to be all-stars. Their bullpen is still pretty strong. Like, what changed about them? And this is not about them winning the World Series repeating. This is about them winning the division at plus 250. So I am going to be banking on Strasburg and Scherzer time and time again until something changes. And we're getting them at plus money.
Yeah, of course. You know, Syndergaard going down, Tommy John kind of deflated Mets fans. There's a lot of question marks, certainly even around that pitching staff in Atlanta. So it'll be interesting to see. I think they're loaded. I think they're ready to rock and roll. Plus, you can never, ever put a price tag on experience. And when we head to the National League Central, lot of experience there. Chicago, St. Louis, Milwaukee, Cincinnati. Talk to me here, Thomas. Who do you think is got the best value to win the division in the National League Central?
So as I said, you know, the NL is looking pretty good for some value plays and should have interesting divisions. And I think the Central should be one of the wildest divisions in the league. We've kind of seen it over the past few seasons. It was 2 years ago that the Cubs and the Brewers played in that one game play-in at the, you know, the final game of the season, 163. We saw the Brewers win that. We have the Cubs at plus 220, the Cardinals also at plus 220, the Reds at plus 270, and then the Brewers at plus 340. You know, the Pirates are there at plus 7,000. We don't want to talk about them. But we have four teams that are kind of in a spot to really make some noise. The Reds made some improvements this year. But for me, the Brewers at plus 340, a team that has been to the playoffs in recent seasons. You know, last year they lost Yelich, who wasn't great. For them, the question will always be starting pitching. They have a phenomenal bullpen. They have enough offense, of course, centered around Yelich. Ryan Braun, he's getting up there in age, but they, you know, really kind of have enough pieces to make some noise. And at plus 350, plus 340, excuse me, I like their value this year. And, you know, they still have Craig Counsell as their manager. So they have some experience. They have enough star power. They just need a little help when it comes to pitching this year.
Yeah, I agree, but they've got all the ingredients to be able to make a legit run at it this year. Nobody knows about the Cubs, the Cardinals getting a little bit older. It's the Brewers, I think, to have. I'm with you. And when you look, and again, we skipped over the Yankees and the Dodgers because there's really no point in talking about those odds for them winning the division, the American League East and the National League East, but they do have some value when it comes to pennant odds. So let's talk about the American League pennant and the New York Yankees. Talk to me about the value that they have right now.
So as you said, the Yankees sitting as the outright for the division is minus 440, which isn't great. Like, we're not even going to pretend that's a great bet to have. But for the pennant, for the AL pennant, they're sitting at plus 165, which is obviously good for a team that's the favorite. The Astros are behind them in second at plus 370. So we kind of factor in everything. You know, the Yankees, in this time off with the league, you know, paused right now, they're going to be getting a little bit healthier, right? We're going to be seeing, you know, Stanton and Judge come back a little bit healthier. And I would say probably the most important piece is probably going to be Paxton. You know, James Paxton, their pitcher, dealing with that back injury, whatever it is, coming back a little bit healthier. You know, what is it, two ALCSs in the past three seasons that they've been to? Finally, hopefully able to get over this hump with Gerrit Cole in the mix now. Like, you know, plus 160, as the season goes on, that should probably get a little bit lower. And this might be the time to grab these odds while you can.
Yeah, I agree. Listen, it's this pause, this layoff, certainly helping the Yankees, who seem to have been bitten by the injury bug over the last couple of years. So certainly favoring them. And the Dodgers are loaded again. I mean, what can you say about the Dodgers? Is there any value in them winning the National League pennant?
Well, there has to be value in them winning the pennant because there's no value in them winning the West. They're minus 1,000 in the West. And it's kind of been like that for a few seasons now. It's like, okay, it's the Dodgers, maybe the Diamondbacks, maybe the Rockies, you know, get the wild card. Maybe they make a bit of noise. But it's minus 1,000 for the Dodgers in the West, and we don't want to be looking there. They are plus 155 for the NL pennant. We know that they have been to the World Series, as we've heard over this past offseason, a number of times in the past few years. They have the experience. You know, Kershaw, we know, is getting up there in age. But for me, give me Walker Buehler as a potential Cy Young candidate. That lineup that they have behind him is absolutely, it was amazing last year. And now they're adding, you know, an MVP candidate in Mookie Betts. You know, they're bringing up young players with Gavin Lux and Dustin May when it comes to hitting and pitching. They have it all. They have the hitting. They have the pitching. They have the experience. Plus 155 for the Dodgers, and the NL pennant is awesome.
Yeah, I'm shocked for both the Yankees and the Dodgers that there is still some value there in the pennant. Look, we're all excited to get sports back. A lot of baseball fans excited to get baseball back. It should be a great season no matter what. Looking forward to that. He is Thomas Vecchio, Number Fire. I'm Joe Ranieri, and that does it. It's another edition of the FanDuel Hurry Up. Be well. We'll talk to you again tomorrow.